Hi friends, today I'm going to be showing you how to prepare coconut and mawa modaks. This is a very simple recipe that you can prepare in a jiffy for Ganesh Chaturthi. I'll be posting more recipes for Ganesh Chaturthi in the following days. Now let's look into the ingredients that we require for coconut and mawa modaks. We would require 1 cup of freshly grated coconut, 200 grams of mawa or milk powder, 1 cup of sugar, 4 pods of cardamom and 2 tablespoons of ghee. Now in few countries and where you stay, if you cannot find khowa or mawa, you can use milk powder. We can also use saffron strands for this recipe. Now in a mixer jar, I'm going to be adding cardamom and sugar. I'm going to grind this into a powder format. Once I finish grinding this cardamom and sugar into a powder format, I'm just going to reserve it. You can also sift the powdered sugar. Make sure there are no hard bits of cardamom in the powdered sugar. I will be using this modak mold. If you do not find modak mold, not an issue. You can still prepare pedas and serve it as it is. This modak molds are easily available in all supermarkets during Ganesh Chaturthi season. I'm going to start preparing the peda mixture. I've heated a wok on medium flame. Once the wok is nice and hot, I've added 2 tablespoons of ghee and placed the flame on low and then added coconut to it. I'm going to fry the coconut till there is no moisture content in the coconut. The coconut has to go completely dry. We need to be patient at this particular process because we need to keep stirring the coconut, otherwise your coconut will burn. Now once the coconut is dry, I'm just going to crumble that mawa and add it to the coconut along with the powdered sugar. You can add nuts, chopped nuts, which is fried in a bit of ghee. Now I'm just going to keep stirring it. I'm not added any sort of moisture or liquid to this particular mixture. The mawa will melt eventually and all the ingredients will get combined. As the sugar and mawa melts, all the ingredients will get combined. So be patient and keep stirring it. In about 5 minutes time, all the ingredients have combined. At this point, you need to be patient and keep stirring it. Moisture from the mawa and the sugar has reduced completely. It should almost turn into a ball sort of consistency. It should not be sticky. The recipe in detail will be posted on my blog. Blog link will be posted in the description box below this video. Or you can click the iCard above this video for regular updates. Do follow me on my social media. You can follow me on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. All the links will be in the description box below this video. For recipes translated in Tamil, you can subscribe to my Tamil channel. The Tamil channel link will also be in the description box below this video, or you can click the iCard above this video. Now in about 5 minutes time, all the ingredients have combined. The peda is ready, the peda mixture is ready. I'm just going to transfer it to a bowl, different bowl, and allow it to cool just a bit. It has to be warm, this mixture has to be warm when we are forming the modak. Now I've removed this from the flame and allowed it to cool for some time before I can handle it. just going to start preparing the modak. So I'm going to place the mixture inside the mold and start preparing the modak. So it's very simple recipe. If you do not have a modak mold, what you can do is you can flatten it on a plate and use a cookie cutter and prepare different shapes of pedas. Once the modak is done, I'm just going to go ahead and serve it. Do try this recipe, friends. It's very simple to prepare. You can add saffron strands to flavor and give you a different color altogether. Or you can also add pista flavoring, and you can add just pistachios to this. That will also be very nice and tasty and crunchy. You can prepare many different variations of the same recipe as per your choice. Normally in shops what they do is they add pistachio flavor and they add chopped pistachio to this peda and they prepare pistachio peda. And in some shops they add saffron strands and they just prepare it with saffron flavor. So I've gone ahead and served my modaks. Do try this recipe, friends, and post your comments. Follow me on my blog for precise measurements and try this recipe, friends. Post your comments. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to me for more videos. Until next time, this is Vidya Lakshmi. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.